For example, lenses formula, lens formula, I think you know.
Yes, sir.
What is the lens formula?
1/V − 1/U = 1/F, sir.
Ah, very good, very good. So equals to 1/F. Okay, this is lens formula.
Yes, sir.
And lens maker's formula, Nana?
1/F = U2/U1 − 1/M2. Oh, 1/R1 − 1/R2.
Ah, right. Right, right. Very good. So 1/F equals to what you are saying, mu 2/μ1.
Yes, sir.
Means mu relative. Huh?
Yes, sir. Mu minus.
Minus 1.
By R1 minus.
1/R1 − 1/R2. Okay. Right. Mari here R1 and R2 are what?
Radius, sir.
Radius of curvature of?
First and second surface.
Right. Correct. First and second mirror. Okay. Second mirror, second surface, kada?
Right.
Means it is the first surface and it is the second surface. Okay. Radius of curvature are R1 and R2. Very good. Okay, leave it. And here, how to take the sign conventions, Nana?
Along incident ray means positive, sir.
Right. Suppose this is the lens. Okay. What we are taking. And light rays are incidenting in this direction. Okay.
R2 is positive, sir.
R1 is positive. R2 is negative.
R2 is negative, sir.
R2 is negative and R1 is positive. Very good, very good. So here, based on this lens formula and lens maker's formula, here we have to focus more today to solve few numericals. Okay, Nana? Suppose I am taking one lens here like this, Nana. Take it as one example. Will we start the examples?
Yes, sir.
Here, this is one example, Nana. I am taking, this is one biconvex lens. Okay.
Okay, sir.
Of radii of curvature, as usual, it is R1 and that is R2. Okay, na? R1, I am taking it as some 30 centimeters. And R2, I am taking it as some 60 centimeters. Okay, Nana?
Yes, sir.
And one object is taken here, Nana. Object. It is at a distance of, okay, object distance. O2P, right? OP, which is the object distance. Object distance means generally we represent with the letter U, kada nana? That is given as, say, here some 60 centimeters. Okay? And refractive index of this glass, so mu equals to, suppose you take it as 3/2. Okay? Here the question is, first, what I am asking, suppose the lens is placed in air. Okay. What is the distance of image formed by the lens? And number two, I am asking here, suppose it is immersed in water. Okay. Water of refractive index, I am taking it as mu equals to. This is 4/3. Okay. Not 3/2. It is 4/3. Okay. Wait, Nana. What happened? Okay. It is, I am taking not 3. It is 4/3. Okay. Then, in the two cases, what is the image distance? V equals to, then in this case, V equals to how much? Okay.
Sir, 1/F and 1/V − 1/U, sir.
Okay, correct. But first of all, you have to know what is F na in this case. F means first of all we have to use the Lenz-Meeker's formula, whatever we wrote here.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So first of all, I think we have to find out the focal length.
Yes, sir.
So focal length means 1 by F is equals to what I have to write here in the formula.
Mu 2 by mu 1.
Mu 2 is what and mu 1 is what?
Air nu chustam kabatti air mu 1, sir. Glass.
Right. Very good. So mu relative is 3 by 2.
Minus
by,
1.
By 1. That is air minus 1 into 1 by R1 minus 1 by R2. Here sign conventions, Nana. This is R1, first surface. R1, I think, positive, and R2 is negative. Very good. R1 positive and R2 negative. So here, if we substitute the values, Nana, 1 by F equals to 3 by 2 minus 1. I think if 1 by F is equals to
40, sir.
Is it 40?
Yes, sir.
Sure?
Yes, sir.
60. 3 by 61. Right. That implies F is equals to 40. Very good. F is equals to 40 centimeters. Right now. Now you can use what 1 by V plus, minus 1 by U equals to 1 by F. Here sign conventions, Nana. U
negative, sir.
This is convex lens I took here. Convex lens means focal length, is it positive or negative for a convex lens?
Negative, sir.
Convex lens.
Positive, sir.
Keep in mind, Nana. Okay, convex lens means always it converges all the rays, Nana.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So converging type anywhere there, concave mirror converges the rays. Here concave, convex lens converges the rays.
Okay, so
converges means focal length is positive, Nana. Okay. That's why convex lens is called as converging lens.
Okay, sir.
Okay, simple. Their concave mirror is identical to convex lens. Their convex mirror is identical to? Here,
sir,
which
concave,
type of?
Sir.
That is simple logic. So, convex lens is converging lens. Okay, Nana?
Yes, sir.
Alright, converging lens. Then how much you get here from 1 by V plus 1 by U? U how much? 60, right? So equals to, I am getting here 1 by F. Focal length, how much I got? 40. That implies I will get 1 by V equals to 1 by 40 minus 1 by 60.
Into 4 into 6, sir. 4 into 6, 40 into 6 is 60 into 4. LCM 240.
240. 240 means 2 by 240.
It's 120.
That implies V is equals to I got plus 120. Am I right?
Sir.
Plus 120 means image is formed on the same side or other side?
Same side, sir.
Same side means, are you saying on the left side or right side?
Left side, sir.
Left side. Okay. So left side. Nana, here object is taken on left side. Means actually from object light rays will come in this direction, kada?
Yes, sir.
In this direction means if you measure in opposite direction from pole left side, that becomes negative.
Right side, sir.
So image will be formed somewhere here. Okay?
Yes, sir.
Right side. Okay? Right, good. And if it is, second question, on if it is immersed in water, then in that case, 1 by F is equals to what I have to write?
mu 2 by 3 by 2 by 4 by 3 minus 1 into 1 by r1 minus 1 by r2.
Very good. 1 by r1. 1 by r1 is how much is that? 1 by r1?
30 minus.
30. Sign convention minus of minus. Minus 60. That is plus. So I think this is 9 by 8 minus 1. 9 by 8 minus 1 is 1 by 8.
Yes, sir.
Into this is 1 by 30 plus 1 by 60. Mm. 3 by 60. Am I right, Nana?
Yes, sir.
3 by 60 means 3 ones are 3 twos are 20.
F equal to 160.
F is equals to, I got 160. Very good. F equals to 160 centimeters means that implies I will get, again using the formula, 1 by F equals to 1 by V minus of minus plus 1 by U. Okay. 1 by U, how much, Nana? 30. 1 by U, 30. That implies. Sorry. U 30, Nana, object distance. So I'm getting 1 by 30 minus 1 by 160.
Excuse sir, man, use kunindi.
Huh?
U 60 sir, pine download chodan sir.
Oh, 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 60, sorry, sorry, sorry. This is U equals to 60. Right, that is R1. Right, right, yes. Sorry, man. So this is 60. Okay, 60 means 60, 160. Okay, what will be the LCM of 60 and 160? Six.
1 by 160 minus 1 by 60
Yeah, you are right. Okay. Minus 1 by 60. Yes. So I think this time you will get virtual minus. 1 by V equals to, I am getting 160 and 60. 480, I think, LCM. 16 threes are, 160 threes are. 6, 8s are. 68s are. So I am getting minus 5 by 480. Am I right, Nana?
1 minute, sir. Yes, sir.
How much finally you got? I got 96 centimeters.
Minus 1 by 96. Yes, sir. 1 by V equal to.
Yeah. So, minus 96 centimeters.
Yes, sir. V equal to minus 96.
Very good. So, minus 96 means this time it forms virtual or real?
Virtual, sir.
So, it forms virtual image. Okay. Virtual means, keep in mind, Nana, it forms the image on the same side or other side?
Same side. So
Here, don't get confused. Yeah, now you told correct only, Nana. It forms the image on the same side, means left side.
Yes, sir.
Very, very, very. So, is it over, Nana, completed?
Yes, sir.
Right, good. Then, here... suppose when you come to exam, I think if it is immersed in water, how to solve, you solved there, Nana.
Yes, sir.
And here, suppose this is like one plano convex lens, Nana. Okay. This is one plane of convex lens. Consider it as a plane of convex lens. Okay. And for this plane of convex lens, what he said, the focal length is equals to, F is equals to, say, some 60 centimeters. Okay? Yes. And object is placed at a distance of, say, some like 240 centimeters. Okay, whose height of object is equals to 3 centimeters, right? What will be the height of image here? Height of image means, first of all, focal length given. So no need to use, I think, lens maker's formula.
Yes, sir.
So directly, I think we can go to 1 by V minus 1 by U, sign convention minus U, equals to 1 by F. This is K, convex lens. Convex lens, focal length is positive. Am I right, Nana?
Yes, sir.
By this, I think you can find out V. Then you may ask, what is the use of finding out V, sir? 80,
sir. 1 by V equal to?
V equals to 80, yeah? Okay, wait 1 minute. 1 by V equals to, I'm getting here, how much? 1 by VF minus 1 by U.
1 by 60 minus 1 by 240, sir.
Correct only. Minus 1 by 240. Right. So, 3 by 240.
80.
Right. F is equals to 80. Accepted. Okay. This is 80 centimeters. Then here he is asking height of image, Nana. How to calculate height of image there?
Sir, mu 2 by mu 1 equal to height of object by height of image into V by U, sir.
That is for single spherical surface, Nana. Yesterday we did with single spherical surface. Convex means it is a combination of two surfaces, Nana. One spherical surface, in this case, one plane surface.
Yes, sir.
So combination of two surfaces, the magnification you will get here, Nana. M is equals to, in the same way like in mirrors, V by U, which is equals to height of image by height of object.
Okay, sir.
Identify the difference, Nana. Their height of image by height of object is equals to, in mirrors you got what?
Minus.
Minus V by U. Did you remember?
Yes, sir.
That is minus V by U. Whereas for lenses, it is plus V by U.
Yes, sir.
Okay. And what you told for single spherical surface, you are saying that is yesterday what we discussed now. Single spherical surface means there is no surface here.
Yes, sir.
That one magnification is equals to, you told like what, mu 2 by mu 1 into, how much you told, Nana?
V by U, sir.
V by U. This is the magnification. Right. This is only for single spherical surface, Nana. Don't use for lenses.
Yes, sir.
Okay, Nana?
Yes, sir.
So, for lenses, this is the formula. I think all the values are given. So, you can find out.
H I equal to 1, sir.
HI equals to 1, V is how much?
V 80, sir. 80 by 240 equal to HI by 3.
Sorry. This is 80, this is V, na?
Yes, sir.
This is V. Okay.
F already just, sir, 60.
Right. So, here, this is V.
Yes, sir.
Very good. I think you are right now. Then V by U, you took actually. 80 by U is 240. Is equals to HI by HO. Okay. 83 is, and HO is also 3 centimeters. But I think you forgot here substituting the sign convention.
Yes, sir.
V is positive. But U is negative or positive?
Minus 1.
Minus 240. So, height of image is equals to, you will get minus 1 centimeter. That indicates image is inverted or erected?
Inverted, sir.
Image is inverted and object here taken is erect. Okay? Object is erect and image is inverted.
Yes, sir.
Right, good. So, here magnification concept also we covered.
Yes, sir.
Okay? So, till now we got a lens formula, lens maker's formula and magnification formula. And here in the same way, suppose I gave here, I take it as example 3 today. this is one convexo-concave surface, Nana. Means like this. One surface given. Means this is convex surface, and if you see from the other side, means right side, it is concave surface. So what? So what is its name? Concave surface. Okay, concave lens. It can be called as convex meniscus. Okay, other name for it. So in numericals, they may ask, suppose one convex meniscus type of lens is taken. Convex meniscus type of lens means this one. Okay. Yes, and here I am taking one object as usual. Okay. This is the object. And here it is taken at a distance of, say, some 20 centimeters. Okay. This is the distance of object.
Means
this
U is equal
to? U equals to 20 even here. So what you said, U equals to 20 centimeters. Okay. And of course, light rays will come in this direction, Nana, as usual. Okay. Am I right?
Yes, sir.
Light rays come in this direction means generally we measure the object distance from pole, that always negative object distance.
Minus
20, right. Here, the radii of curvature of both given as R1 equals to 2R2. Okay?
Yes,
and here, the refractive index of the medium given as 3 by 2.
Air, by 2, sir?
Outside air, as usual. Okay? Placed in air.
Okay,
sir. Here I am writing.
Lens maker formula you
use, sir. Lens maker's formula we can use. Okay. Then he is saying that here the image is formed, okay, at a distance of say some 60 centimeters on the same side.
And V60, sir.
V60 image is formed on the same side at a distance of 60 centimeters.
Light ray vachina direction lo unnana, sir?
On the same side means on the side of object.
Negative ga, sir. V
kuda. Obviously, very good. So V is negative. Then what are the radii of curvature? R1 equals to how much? And R2 equals to how much? First, I think with the information of U and V, what can you find?
1 by F, sir.
Very good. First, try to find out what is 1 by F using the lens formula. Is equals to 1 by V, which is negative, minus 1 by U, that is also negative. That is equals to 1 by minus V is 60, minus of minus plus, 1 by U is 20. That I am getting 2 by 16. How much you got now of focal length?
That's the same, sir.
Same, Anna?
Yes, sir.
30 centimeters. Sure?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Focal length is 30 centimeters.
R2 equal to 15 by 2, sir.
15 by 2, na? Sure?
Yes, sir.
So, lens maker's formula 1 by F is equals to mu minus 1. That is 1 by 2. Into 1 by R1 sine convention, how much you took, Nana?
Positive, sir.
R1 positive. Very good. R2?
Negative, sir.
I think here you took wrong, right?
Negative is kunan, sir, actually. Minus is kunan, sir.
Here minus. And R2 sine convention will be?
Minus, sir.
No. You see here, this is what convexo meniscus, kada. Both are will be like this. Means yes, it forms the radius of curvature, means center will come here. For this side also, I think center will come somewhere here.
Yes, sir.
both the centers are forming in the same direction of light, kada?
So positive, sir.
That's why here the radii of curvature of both will be positive. So you took here minus a plus a.
Minus is correct, sir.
I think you may correct. You may be, your answer may be correct. 1/2 15 is a cancellation. 1/15 is equals to, I am getting 1/r1. R1 is 2r2 minus 1/r2. That is one. R
minus s, sir. Minus 1/2r2, sir. Sorry, the.
1/2r2 minus 1/r2, 2r2, 1 minus, -1/2r2.
Yes, sir.
So 1/f is equals, means, sorry, 1/15 equals to, how much I will get?
Minus 1/2r.
Minus 1/2r. Yeah, correct, correct, correct. Minus 1/15 equals to minus 1/2r2. Means R2 is equals to, I am getting?
Minus 15/2.
Right. Minus 15/2.
Minus 1.
Okay. Of course, that is sign convention. So, minus. Here, and R1 will be?
Minus 15.
Right. Minus 15. Okay. Right. Yes, this is the story now. Okay. Means actually what he asked in the question, if you observe properly, he gave, it is convex or concave. Okay. Convex or concave, and here, if you see the two radii of curvature after substituting in the formulae, I got how much, Nana? R1 negative, R2 negative.
Yes, sir.
Both are negative means actually the lens should be appeared not convex or concave. It should be appeared like this.
Opposite direction.
Means here, then only you will get R1 and R2, both will be negative if you take the object here. Am I right?
Sir.
So here, I think in the problem, he mentioned the name convex or concave is wrong. It is concave or convex.
Okay, sir.
Why? Because object side, both the surfaces are in the shape of concave or convex?
Concave, sir.
So it is appeared like a concave meniscus. Okay. Means what I am saying is the name is correct, but in the problem, he did not give the diagram, Nana. So I think he took the object this side, Nana, right, sir?
Position of object is
He took the object on the right side. So when light rays come from right side to the lens like this, the surface is appeared like concave. So it is concave meniscus. Understood, Nana?
Yes.
The difference between convex meniscus and concave meniscus here.
Yes.
Good. So this is the another model, Nana, here, what we took, right?
Yes, sir.
Next, here, we come to other one, example. This one, in all type of exams covered, Nana, another example here. This is one plane or convex lens, setup. Plane or convex lens. But here, the thickness of plano convex lens at the principal axis, this is the thickness, Nana. Is it visible?
Yes, sir.
That thickness he gave here as some 2 centimeters. Okay? But keep in mind, Nana, generally we take all the lenses very thin, means this thickness at the center is negligible.
Okay, sir.
Okay. But he gave in the problem, if the thickness is considered, how to find the focal length. Okay.
Okay, sir.
And here, this is called as aperture length, Nana. Like yes, diameter. Okay. Aperture length. that aperture length is given as 10 centimeters. Okay.
Yes.
It is placed in air. Okay. And here its refractive index is equals to as usual 3 by 2 of lens. Refractive
yes.
index of lens is 3 by 2, but it is placed in air. Then what is its focal length? F equals to how much? That is the question now.
Sir.
Okay. This type of question, straight away we can't use mu relative d minus 1 into 1 by F equals. Mu relative minus 1 into 1 by R1 minus 1 by R2.
Yes, sir.
Why? Because that is derived for thin lenses. Means here the thickness is negligible. Okay. If thickness is considered, how to solve? For that, for plane of convex lens, directly if you use the formula F1 by F equals to, this is what on a plane of convex lens.
Yes, sir.
Okay,
yes, sir.
Plane of convex lens here, the focal length is formula mu minus 1 into 1 by R1, first surface now. Radius of curvature, I take it as R minus 1 by R2. How much you write now? Second surface is a plane surface, straight line. Plane surface, what is the radius of curvature?
Zero, no, sir.
No, Nana, it is infinity.
Okay, sir.
Okay, so keep in mind, plane surface radius of curvature is infinity. 1 by infinity, that will be 0. So you will get focal length is equals to formula mu minus 1 into 1 by R. What I said, this R actually not given in the problem.
Yes, sir.
To use the lens maker's formula. For that, what he is saying, you use some mathematics here, master. How? Suppose this is one circle or sphere. Okay. Any lens is actually formed from sphere only, Nana.
Yes, sir.
Okay. There, you cut the part till here. Okay. And you took only this much part and named it as plano convex lens.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Principal axis means generally we take from center. This is the principal axis generally what we take. Okay, Nana?
Radius.
With the radius R. Okay. Now my question is, this is actually diameter.
Yes, sir.
And it is a chord.
Yes, sir, chord.
So here in circles or sphere, suppose two chords like here, what we took the two things, the two chords intersect according to the chord's principle. Suppose the part here after intersecting is x1 and the remaining part from here to there in the sphere or circle, this is x2. X2 means from here to there, nano, full thing. Okay. X1 means only this much part, it is x1. And this part is y1, this vertical part till here, point of intersection. And the lower part is suppose y2, okay? Then the chord's principle is x1 into x2 means multiplication of these two parts is equals to y1 into y2.
Y1 into y2.
Do you know this principle on a chord's intersection principle? Okay.
I don't know, sir.
Okay, right. Now you try to remember, Nana. These circles, I think you may get in your
second
circles chapter, huh? X1 into
okay,
equals to Y1 into Y2. So I'm going to use that principle here, Nana, chord's intersection principle.
Okay, sir.
Now check here, Nana. Will you say X1 is how much in this question?
2, sir.
So I know in the, according to the formula, I know here the values. So here I am writing X1 is equals to 2 centimeters. Very good. Will you say X2, Nana? I think what is the total part here?
X1 plus X2, sir.
No, I think here, this is what, Nana, this line, total line, full horizontal line.
Yes, sir.
This is diameter, na?
Yes, sir.
Diameter means 2 times 2 radius, na?
Yes, sir.
2R, this is.
Minus 2R minus X1.
Ah, that's it. So, X2 is equals to, I am writing here, okay? This is 2R minus X1. That equals to 2R minus X1 given as 2. Okay. This is. And Y1 and Y2 will you tell, Nana?
Y1, 5, equal to just 5, 5 out there, sir.
Obviously. Why? Because the horizontal line is diameter. Na? Diameter means equally.
So, equally.
Right. So Y1 is equals to Y2 equals to, you are writing how much? 5 centimeters.
Yes, sir.
From this chords intersection principle, will you say what is radius of curvature, Nana? Try to find out. In the meanwhile, I also try.
Yes, sir.
X 2R into 2R minus X 1 2 is equals to Y 1 into Y 2, 25. So here 2 also taken out, 4. So R minus 1 is equals to 25 by 4.
R equal to 21 by 4, sir.
R is equals to, I think, 29 by 4, Nana.
Yes, sir.
Correct?
Correct, sir.
29 by 4 centimeters. Okay. So you know the radius of curvature, Nana. Now you can go to Lenz-Meyer's formula straight away after finding out the radius of curvature.
1 by r equal to mu minus 1 by r, sir.
That's it. Very good. Mu minus 1 is 1 by 2. This is 4 by 29. 1 by r is.
F is equal to 29 by 2, sir.
Yes. That implies F is equals to, you are writing here. F is equals to 20.2. Right. That is 14.5 centimeters. So understood, Nana, how to find out when, if they give what the thickness of lens.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So you have to remember here the chords intersection principle, Nana.
Yes, sir.
So will you remember this formula?
Yes, sir.
X1 into X2 is equals to Y1 into
Y2.
Very good, very good. Then will we go to another example, Nana?
Yes, sir.
Another example here. Suppose if I say this is one biconvex lens, Nana. Okay. And here along its aperture, okay, they call it as diameter, Nana. Along the aperture or diameter, I am splitting it into two equal parts.
Like plano concave.
Right. If I cut that into two equal parts, two plano convex lenses will be formed like this.
Yes, sir.
Am I right, Nana?
Yes, sir.
In this case, suppose the focal length of this biconvex lens is F, what will be the focal length of each part if they ask?
F by 2, sir.
Generally, we think that is F by 2. But that is F by 2, Nana.
Sir?
That is not F by 2.
Okay, sir.
If it is suppose F dash each, okay, see here. Consider to understand, Nana, this is equiconvex lens. Equiconvex lens means radii of curvatures are equal.
R1 equal to R2.
Very good. Let it be some R.
Yes, sir.
So, what will be the focal length according to Lenz-Meyer's formula? 1 by F is equals to mu minus 1 into biconvex.
0, sir. 1 by R minus 1 by R, sir.
But where are the sign conventions, Nana?
Okay, sir.
R1 is plus. So what about?
R2 is minus of minus plus.
Right. So here F is equals to, I am getting 1 by r plus 1 by r, 2 by r.
Yes, sir.
So r by 2 into mu minus 1 you will get, reciprocating the f now. Okay, this 1 by f is equals to mu minus 1 into 2 by r you will get.
Yes, sir.
So f, by taking the reciprocal of that one, you will get r by 2 mu minus 1. Okay?
Yes, sir.
Let it be equation 1.
One.
After cutting, you are saying that it is a plane of convergence. Plane of convergence, easily you can tell. Why? Because in the above, there I wrote already. 1 by f is
by f equal to mu minus 1 by r. F is equal to r by mu minus 1.
That implies f dash here, f dash equals to, you will get r by mu minus 1. So look at, this is f r by 2 times 2 mu minus 1.
Yes, sir.
So can I write here, f is equals to r by mu minus 1 is replaced with f dash.
Yes, sir.
So can I write here, this is f dash by,
f by 2, f is equal to, yes, sir.
F dash is equals to how much you are getting?
2f.
Not f, f by 2.
Yes, sir.
So after cutting, you are getting the focal length will be doubled. This is 2f and that is also 2f.
Okay, sir.
Okay. And here, he tries to confuse you, Nana, when you come to numericals. What they, at what point they try to confuse us, sir? Okay, if you ask, after cutting the by equiconvex lens into two parts, after cutting, these two parts are again joined like this setup. This is the first plane of convex lens. And here, this is the second plane of convex lens. They are joined like this. Okay, after joining, then what will be its combined focal length? Its combined focal length.
F dash plus f dash 4f, sir.
There again, we are doing the mistake. Okay. When two lenses are kept in contact, Nana, effective focal length formula is 1 by f is equals to 1 by f1 plus 1 by f2. This is formula.
Okay, okay, sir.
Suppose three lenses are kept in contact plus 1 by f.
1 by f1 plus f, 1 by f2 plus 1 by f3.
Like. So 1 by, better I take effective focal length as capital F. Nana. Okay. Is equals to 1 by f1. First part focal length is 2f. Na?
Yes, sir.
And second one is also 2f. Na? So 1 by 2f plus 1 by 2f, I will get 2 by 2f. That is 1 by f. Am I right?
Yes, sir.
And I am getting here that implies f is equal to effect length is equal by reciprocating both. I am getting f only, Nana.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So here keep in mind, after cutting, again if they join, same either like this, either like this means after cutting these two, directly suppose they joined with the Fevicol or Fevikwik like this right away.
2f,
yeah, that is also f, this is also f, or else if you join them like this, first one taken as usual, second one is reversed like this, suppose.
Yes, sir.
Means from these examples, what you understood from the first,
focus
second,
not be changed, sir. After
Yeah, so focal length is independent of arranging them while placing in contact, independent of the arrangement while keeping them in contact. Okay, right. Don't try to say here the focal length is minus f nana. Why? Because students will argue, sir, it is appeared like a biconcave lens, sir. It is appeared like. Okay, so why? Take its focal length as negative. Okay. It is appeared like biconcave, but it is not biconcave.
But it's not biconcave. Yes, sir.
Yeah. So, understood?
Understood, sir.
Very good. So here, this is one model, a cutting model.
Yes, sir.
And in this cutting model, they may ask one more question. Suppose if it is the biconvex lens, Now I am cutting along the principal axis. Along the principal axis means after cutting, this is one piece. Okay. And here bottom one, this is another piece. Okay. Cut here, Nana, along the principal axis, not along the diameter. Here, what will be the focal length of each if the focal length of original one is F? Then, if you see from this argument, what means from this explanation here,
sir,
why I got here 2F, if you check there, before cutting, it has two curved surfaces.
Yes, sir.
After cutting, only one curved surface you have. So now,
yes,
curved surfaces, they're changed.
Yes, sir.
The length is changed. But here, after cutting and before cutting, it has two spherical surfaces or one spherical surface?
Two, sir.
Before cutting, it has two. After cutting also, it has two.
Yes, sir.
It has two, four curved surfaces means number of curved surfaces changed or not?
Changed, sir.
Number of curved surfaces?
No, sir. Constant.
Same. That's why focal length will not be changed. F dash is equals to, still it has two spherical surfaces. The focal length will be F only.
Okay, sir.
Understood my explanation, Nana?
Yes, sir.
What is that? Before cutting, it has two spherical surfaces. After,
yes, sir.
Also, it has two spherical
surfaces. Two spherical surfaces. So, its focal length will be constant.
Right. Number of spherical surfaces change.
Focal length. If it changes, then focal length changes. So, if it doesn't change, it means constant.
Focal length remains constant. Very. Okay, na?
Yes, sir.
Then here, related to this question, suppose after cutting like this, okay, here I am taking one example. Suppose after cutting, these two parts, upper part and lower part, this is upper part and this is the lower part I am taking here. And it is the original principal axis. Both are shifted by 1 centimeter each in another. Means what will be the separation between these two?
2 centimeters.
Each shifted by 1 centimeter. If I take one object here at a distance of 30 centimeters, okay, and focal length of the original lens, I am taking it as 10 centimeters. Means focal length of each will be here 10 or 20, Nana?
10, sir.
It will not be changed. 10 centimeters. Lower part is also 10 centimeters. Okay. The upper part forms one image somewhere here. And the lower part also forms the image somewhere here. Then the question is, if it is the image formed by the first upper part and it is the image formed by the second lower part, what will be the separation between the two images? Jesus. Means this separation will be how much? Okay. This,
yes,
model actually we did in mirrors, Nana, no problem.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
So here, first of all, better. Why? Because he is asking the height of image above the principal axis. Height of the image above the principal axis means, first of all, we have magnification formula, Nana. Height means, am I right?
Yes, sir. V by U equal to H by
H. So we require first V. Why? Because V is not given here.
1 by F is equal to 1 by U plus 1 by V minus 1 by U equal to 1 by F.
Right. 1 by V minus 1 by U is minus U equals to 1 by F. So, will you find what will be the V, Nana, there quickly?
Yes, sir. 1 by F minus 1 by U. Sir.
So, after finally substituting all the values, how much you told, Nana, V is equals to, that implies?
15.
So 15 centimeters. Yeah, exactly. You are right. V is equals to 15 centimeters. But here,
1 by 2 ratio, sir. HA by HO equal to 1 by 2, sir.
Correct. Here, HA, O, how?
HO positive this call, HA negative this call, sir.
Whatever it may be. It means, okay, for the upper one, object is below.
Yes, sir.
For the lower one, object is above the lens.
Above. Yes, sir.
So here, just to, we require the heights here. So I think both are 1 centimeter only. Am I right? Height of object for both the lenses.
Yes, sir.
1 centimeter means here, if I take the lower one.
Sir.
Okay. Means lower half. Then what you said, I think correct. The object is above the principal axis for the lower half. So HO, how much you take here, Nana? 1 centimeter, 2 centimeter, sir.
1 centimeter, sir.
Then use the magnification formula. V.
HI equal to 1 by 2.
Very good, very good. V by U. U 30, but minus 30. V by U equals to sign convention, minus 30. V,
yes, sir, sir.
Equals to HI, I don't know. By HO, HO is
minus.
Plus 1 centimeter. For the,
okay,
lower, for the lower half.
Okay, sir.
So H
minus 1 by 2.
HI equals to minus 1.
Minus 1 by 2.
Minus 1 by 2 means 0.5 centimeters.
Yes, sir.
So I think you told this is minus 0.5, means 0.5 centimeters below the principal axis.
Yes, sir.
I think no need to find out the above part. Same height.
Same.
Object,
yes, sir. Same height. Sir.
Same height. Means you will get 0.5. So what will be between the two images?
One.
Right. So I1, I2 distance is equals to 1 centimeter here. The distance between the two. So understood this model, Nana?
Yes, sir.
We completed both models. Okay. After cutting and separating, what happens here? In the case parallel to the principal axis also, after cutting and separating, what happens here?
Yes, sir.
So both the models, are they clear, Nana?
Yes, sir.
Right. Now come to another model here.
Okay, sir.
Here, I'm asking one question. This is very different model, Anna.
Okay.
That is, suppose this is one, either equi-convex lens or biconvex lens or concave. Okay. Suppose I take one plano-convex lens like this. Okay. This is one plano-convex lens. For this plano-convex lens, what he is saying, suppose if I silver the plane surface, okay, suppose plane surface is silvered, obviously it behaves as a mirror, Nana.
Yes, sir.
And mirror that too, if I take the object here, first of all, you can find
convex.
Refraction at a convex surface, reflection at a plane surface.
Yes, sir.
This is plane surface. And,
again, reflection on convex mirror.
And again, finally, forms somewhere image here.
Yes, sir.
So, the convex lens here, in the convex lens, if the plane surface is silvered, the image, real image is formed on the same side, means it is behaving like a concave mirror. Why? Because image is formed on the same side due to reflection in case of concave mirror only.
Okay. Yes, sir.
So it behaves as, after silvering the plane surface, it behaves as which type of lens? Theoretical question. If they ask, we can put the option concave mirror.
Okay, sir.
Then in this case, what will be the focal length of this plano convex lens after silvering the plane surface? If they ask, then we have to use the lengthy derivation, Anna, that I am actually avoiding that lengthy derivation.
Sir.
First of all, we have to take the refraction at plane surface using the formula mu 1 by u minus mu 2 by v. Yesterday we derived this one, mu 1 minus mu 2 by r. Am I right?
Yes, sir.
Using that formula, and again plane surface object distance is equals to image distance, and again refraction at the concave is this spherical surface, again using this formula. That will be a lengthy derivation.
Yes, sir.
So to avoid this derivation, what I am going to do, simple, can I consider here the first refraction at plane surface means first it behaves as plano convex lens.
Yes, sir.
Am I right?
Yes, sir.
And second one, it is reflecting at the surface means it behaves as a mirror. Correct. This is plane surface or spherical surface?
Plane.
So behaves as, okay, plane mirror. Okay. And third one, again refraction occurred na there. Due to that refraction, it behaves as, again, that is which lens? Plano convex.
Plano convex.
So if you see here, two times it is behaving like a lens, one time it is behaving like a mirror. Okay. And
yes, sir.
The shortcut, these three are, okay, appear to be kept in contact. Appear to be kept in contact means previous problem we solved, 1 by F, 1 kept in contact, 1 by F1 plus 1.
F1 plus 1 by F2 plus 1 by F3.
Here for the 3. So it is our shortcut. Okay. So we have to find out the effective focal length using this shortcut. So here 1 by F1 plus 1 by F2 plus 1 by F3 means again F3 equals to F1.
Yes, sir.
Why?
2F1, 2 by F1 plus 2 by
F2. First and last it is behaving like a lens.
Yes, sir.
So you can write here again further like 2 by F1 as a shortcut. 2 by F1
plus 1 by F2.
Simple. This is a simple shortcut. But okay, no?
Yes, sir.
So I'm going to use this shortcut, Anna. Plano convex lens, focal length, I know 1 by F is equals to, means F1 is equals to here
mu
minus 1 into plano convex. So 1 by R. That's it.
Yes, sir.
1 by R or 2 by R?
1 by R into 2, yes, 2 R.
But it is only plano convex, kada? It has only spherical surface.
Yes, sir.
Only one spherical surface.
One, sir.
So 1 by R. Right?
Yes, sir.
And plane mirror, focal length is for plane mirror. Nana. Okay.
1 by V plus 1 by V.
Focal length.
2 R.
1 by F2 equals to focal length is 1 by R by 2. Focal length of mirror is R by 2. Na?
Yes, sir.
So radius of curvature of plane surface in the previous problem already I told one model. Plane surface, the radius of curvature is infinity.
Yes, sir.
You said zero that time. Remember?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
So radius of curvature is infinity. 1 by infinity you will get focal length.
Zero.
This is zero. So straight away you can calculate here 1 by F is 2
by F.
2 by 2 into 1 by F1. Am I right this part?
Yes, sir.
2 into 1 by F1. 1 by F1 you calculated here. Am I right?
Yes, sir. F effective equal to R by 2 into mu minus 1.
Very good, very good, very good. Mu minus 1 into 1 by R. That in plus what you told on F is R by 2 2 into mu.
Mu minus 1.
Very good. This is the formula. Okay.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
But while coming to the problems, Nana, we have to put a negative sign, option.
Okay, sir.
This is concave mirror or convex mirror?
Concave mirror.
Concave mirror focal length in mirrors chapter.
Minus.
Focal
minus.
Right. So you understood, Nana?
Yes, sir.
Okay, okay. Based on this, it's already 11:20. Will we stop or will I give one example?
Your wish, sir.
Okay, we complete with one example, Nana, here. Today class.
Yes, sir.
Right, take here one example. This is biconvex lens, Nana, equiconvex lens. Okay. Its focal length is given as, better we take instead of focal length, we have to find out that. Okay. Okay, no problem. Its focal length is equals to, say, 20 centimeters, Nana. Okay. And its refractive index mu is equals to 3/2. And one object is placed at a distance of, say, some 40 centimeters. This is u, Nana. Okay. But here, this spherical surface is silvered. Okay. After silvering, object is placed at its 40 centimeters. Find the image distance. V equals to how much?
And the first convex lens, malli concave mirror, convex lens.
Very good. Means here, 2/f1, you can say. You can take it as f1. F1 20 centimeters. Directly, you can substitute here, f1 20. But a concave mirror, okay, means the second one you are telling. Am I right?
Yes, sir.
Concave mirror means focal length f2 will be, I think, r/2.
Yes, sir.
Mirror. But radius of curvature here not given?
Yes, sir.
So radius of curvature means, I think you have to find out the radius of curvature using lens maker's formula.
Sir.
Mu minus 1 into, take it as equiconvex lens. Equiconvex lens means R1 is equals to R2. Let it be R.
F is equal to R, plus I pay.
This is how much you are taking mu minus 1 into here?
2 is 3/2, sir. Mu 1 is 1, sir.
1/2.
1/2 into 2/r. F is equal to R.
Very good. F is equals to R. Means radius of curvature is equals to 20 centimeters.
Yes, sir.
Then F2 will be, I think, here equals to 20/2, 10 centimeters.
Yes, sir.
Okay, right. Then try to find out the focal length first, Nana. 1/f is equals to 2/f1. 20.
Plus 1/f2.
10.
20 plus 1/10. 5, sir. 5, sir.
F is equals to 5. Very good. 40/4. That is equals to f. 20/4. Correct only. 20/4, 5 centimeters. You are right, Nana. Okay?
Yes, sir.
It is equals to 5 centimeters. And confirm, it behaves as concave mirror or convex mirror?
Concave mirror, sir.
Why? Because your convex side is silvered.
Yes, sir.
Okay, very good. So it behaves as concave mirror. Nana, I am getting some doubt. Here, suppose this is some equi-concave lens, Nana.
Sir.
Suppose the concave surface is silvered, then it behaves as?
First convex, sir. Then convex and convex. Now,
two times biconcave lens. Concave lens, concave lens. First and three.
Malli, sir, concave mirror, sir.
Convex.
Convex.
Convex mirror or concave mirror?
Convex mirror, sir.
So finally it behaves as convex or concave?
Convex, sir.
So I think you understood. This behaves as convex mirror.
Yes, sir.
Okay, so what is the logic here? Convex surface is silver, behaves as concave mirror.
Yes, sir.
Means convex lens is silver, plano convex lens or biconvex lens? Convex lens is silver, it behaves as concave mirror.
Concave. If concave surface is mirror, then it behaves as convex mirror.
Means concave mirror lens is silver, then it behaves as convex mirror.
Yes, sir.
Right, good. And now come back to the formula, Nana. Mirror formula. It behaves as a mirror. Concave mirror.
Yes, sir.
So mirror formula 1 by V, not plus 1 by, sorry, not minus 1 by U. It will be 1 by V plus 1 by U equals to 1 by F. Am I right?
Yes, sir.
Mari here U is, I think, negative.
Yes, sir.
Sign convention. Focal length. You told that it is concave mirror. Concave mirror focal length. Sign convention.
Negative, sir.
Right. Now try to find out what is 1 by V. By U minus 1 by F. So 1 by 40 minus 1 by F is 5. 8. 8 by 40.
40 by 7. Minus 40 by 7, sir.
Very good. Very good. Very good. So minus 40 by 7. Right. So this is minus.
Sir,
are you able to see, Nana? 1 minute, Nana. So finally, V is equals to minus 40 by 7. Okay, right. No problem. So now you understood, Nana, how to solve?
Yes, sir.
Very good, very good. Right, right. No problem, no problem. So is it clear?
Yes, sir.